Hey everyone, welcome back to Red Dead Redemption 2. Apparently my horse doesn't want to come to me. There we go, we're going fishing, finally. I thought we were going fishing last time, but apparently we weren't.
So how far is this creek?
It's a bit of a ride still, and it's not a creek. It's the same lake we camped on, just a different part. It'll be worth it. I saw some big drum and sturgeon there. Should be rock bass, bluegills, perch, pickerel too. It's a good spot.
We'll see if you're as good at catching fish as you are at catching criminals, Arthur.
Trelawney owes me for that.
Trelawney owes everyone for something, but his information is good.
Plus, we are now ingratiated with the local law. I'd say it was a worthwhile diversion all around.
Trelawney's like a bad penny.
I'm not sure how good a magician he is, but he's certainly good at disappearing when he feels like it.
Where does he go?
Everywhere and nowhere, it seems.
We wouldn't everywhere and nowhere.
If he hadn't been weaseling around down that way, though.
Hey, Dutch, remember that time you found him in the outhouse?
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, sorry, Dutch.
We hadn't seen him in weeks. We stopped in some dead-end town in the middle of nowhere. Don't even remember the name.
You and Bill were off doing something, Arthur.
So, we pick up some supplies. I go to relieve myself, open the door, and there's Trelawney, sitting there, newspaper in hand. Mr. Vandalin, I said, what the hell are you doing here? And he said, I could ask you the same thing. If you wouldn't mind giving me a little privacy, I ate a rotten oyster.
Hey, maybe there are actually 100 Trelawneys.
What a terrible thought.
So, you're going back to see that Sheriff Gray?
Yeah, I don't see why not. They don't know who we are down here.
He didn't seem the sharpest of tacks. Neither did that deputy.
If he thinks we can be useful to him, he can certainly be useful to us. A little hiding in plain sight.
I feel like we're always hiding in plain sight.
This is the spot. Down to the left there.
So yeah, we had quite a long episode last time because it just didn't really seem to finish, but we're now into chapter 3, so that's cool. Looking forward to exploring roads. Oh, we're going to get a boat, are we? That's cool. We had the choice to do this fishing or not, but obviously we've got to choose to do it. I think you miss so much if you just don't do some of the like little activities and stuff.
I'm sure nobody would mind if we borrowed one of these. Come on.
Watch it.
Why are you riding like that?
I'm not riding like anything. Here we go. Do I need my weapons? I've got my pistols, I guess.
All right. This looks like a fine vessel.
Okay. Come on, Arthur. Let's get her in the water.
Okay.
I got a good feeling about fishing here. It's supposed to be some incredible sturgeon.
Oh. Okay, here we go. Let me row. You boys are too old for real labor no more.
You're too dumb for anything else.
You're still too good for me, old man.
I enjoy picking on children. Now take us to the deeper water and pray for... good luck and stupid fish.
Well, what about stupid luck and good fish?
That'll do too. Keep going.
Looks like the Assassin's Creed speedboats again.
Good luck, gentlemen.
should really come here at dawn or dusk. That's when you catch the best fish. We should use a lake lure. That'll give us a much better chance of hooking something big like...
Lake lure. Oh.
Sturgeon.
What's wrong with a good old worm?
Oh, worms are good for tiddlers like bluegill and rock bass, but you'd have to be real lucky to catch a sturgeon with one.
Lures it is, then. You heard the expert, Arthur.
Okay.
Let's bait up.
Keep the lure moving slowly on the water so it looks like a little fish just asking to be eaten.
Okay.
You got a bite there, Arthur.
Now reel him in, Arthur.
Okay.
I think that's a bite. Got him?
Get him. It's like Sega bass fishing all over again. Look at him. He's a massive one. Oh, I'm going to get him. I shouldn't have like thrown the line out so far, I guess.
Look at this beauty.
Nice. Arthur, nice.
Well done, Arthur.
They can grow a lot bigger than that. Fella told me he once saw a monster lake sturgeon near the mouth of the river, just southwest of Saint Denis. 50 pounder, he reckoned.
I would like to see that. Hey, Hosea. Remember that time we sent Arthur out fishing? He came back with 3 beautiful bass.
Not this again.
I don't think I do.
Oh, yeah. You do. He was maybe 20. 21. Walked in all full of himself. We had a big feast. Toasted him all night.
This was 15 years ago.
Oh, I remember now.
Then, the next week, Arthur and I are at the market, and Fishmonger calls out, "So how did you enjoy those bass?"
Look, you can fish, or you can go drinking all day, rob someone, and fish.
It's true.
There he is.
Ha, got
ya. It's true.
I should have had that one. I used to go fishing with this feller back in the day. Wesley, his name was. Real miserable bastard, but he loved to fish. We go out all the time. But one day, we were river fishing when we see a funeral procession going over the bridge, and out of the blue, Wesley stands up, takes off his hat, bows his head. Then he sits down, picks his rod back up, and carries on. Doesn't say a word. So I'm a little surprised and say, "Wesley, that was nice of you." He replies, "Well, felt I had to. After all, I was married to her for 30 years.
There he is.
Oh, dear God. I might swim to shore.
Shit. Got away.
You got something biting, Arthur.
Ah.
Remember those big salmon I caught in Montana last year? We had a banquet planned that night until Copper went and stopped the lot.
You never had control of that dog.
Yeah, it's in spirit, though. Never lost the puppy in him, right to the end.
You know, I remember us saying how Blackwater was the furthest east we'd ever been. As a group, I mean.
Feels like the more we try to head west, the further east we end up.
We had all those safe spots picked out to lie low in New Austin, after the ferry job?
I liked it there. Still open and wild, the way it should be. Somehow the desert makes you feel... closer to the sky.
No point us trying to get back that way anytime soon. Pinkertons have patrols out all over tall trees and great plains we saw when we went back for Sean.
Well, look at us now, huh? It could be worse. Plans change. That's just how life goes.
Fish on the line, Arthur.
You're getting the hang of this. Did I ever tell you my mother's buried in Blackwater?
Really? She is?
Apparently so. I only found out from an uncle of mine years later. Last I knew, she was still outside Philadelphia. I left home at 15 and didn't see her again. She and I didn't always see eye to eye. I wasn't always a very obedient child.
I can only imagine.
Still, I loved her in my own way, and she me in hers. Somehow, even from the grave, she managed to have the last laugh. Just gotta reel him in now, Arthur.
Something's nibbling. Got one! Well done.
Nearly. Yes, got him. You got this bass we're getting. I'm gonna give this all to Pearson, I think.
Arthur's pleased with that one.
I actually genuinely really like this fishing. It's actually really nice, especially when you're doing it with the others and they're telling you stories and stuff. What's that thing on the surface? Is that a snake?
Got a nibble there, Arthur?
Nice. I sure do. This fish we got.
Grill up nice. That feels like a bite. There we go.
It's good fun.
On
the hook,
Arthur.
Okay.
There you go.
There we go. Got over 2 kilos on that one. It's a big one. Nah, 1.98. Oh, I don't have any more space.
You don't kill everything.
Got a bite.
Come on, Arthur.
Not bad.
There we go. Give me more honor. Can we,
Hey, I reckon we call it a day, fellas.
Yeah, already? We're good. I've got too much fish.
Been chasing down outlaws. All right. I think we got a decent haul here. Pearson will be happy. Should we head back?
We could keep the boat not too far back to camp from here.
Good idea. Could be useful.
What about the horses?
Well, they'll find their way back.
Just follow the shore south, Arthur.
That was fun. Thank you, boys. Now, Hosea.
Yes.
How about a song?
Okay. all right, I got one for you. I asked that gal to give me some.
I asked that gal to give me some. She says, wait till the taters is done. I couldn't wait till the tails was done. I couldn't wait till the tails was done. Threw her on the floor and knocked off some.
What? stamina.
That was pretty good. But you know, what song we should be singing?
What?
Well, look at us. Three mariners.
Ah, of course.
Well, we be three poor mariners to leak up from the seas. We spend our lives in jeopardy while others live at ease. Shall we go dance this round, round, round? Shall we go dance this round, round, round? Nay, that is a bully boy, come pledge me on this round, 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 round.
Awesome. Here we go, back at camp.
All right.
That was really fun. I like that a lot.
We gonna be okay. I know. Oh, I always know. Whenever I got you two by my side, things are gonna be just fine.
That's a view.
Will be good for us. For now, anyway.
I hope so.
Go see Pearson.
I'll give these fish to Pearson.
Yeah, same here. Who's LS? Yeah, you do that, yeah. Oh, it's Strauss.
Ah, Herr Morgan.
Herr Strauss.
How are you enjoying yourself here?
Money lending.
Well enough, I guess. And you?
Well, it turns out the pursuit of freedom is not a cheap business. Not for us, and not for some of the locals.
Sharking already.
I prefer to call it banking.
You ain't the one handing out the beatings.
No, but I am the one feeding the women and children in the camp. What choice do we have, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know. Come on, tell me.
Here's the list. Refinery worker turned hunter by the name of Vinton Holmes. You'll find him up in the hills north of Strawberry. Ah, an apprentice undertaker. This one working in Rose. His name was Gwen Hughes.
And how many of them do you think will be able to pay?
With enough encouragement, both of them.
I want to get back to our tent, which is right here, because I figure now we're in the south, we need to probably not wear a coat. Seems a bit hot here for a coat. If we're not going to wear a coat, probably want to change some of the we probably don't want any gloves. Probably should go and buy some new clothes. Quite like that one. Unless we've got a very light coat. But I think we do. Because that's fairly light. That actually probably... Well, I still think it seems a bit hot for this. For a coat. Okay. Oh. Of course we didn't have a hat. Okay. Cool. Now, one thing I do want to do is kind of head into town. Let's have a look on our map, because we haven't really had a look. Okay. GR. Grays. Gwynny Hughes. Billy Midnight is there. Gunsmith. Okay, cool. Okay. And here we've got Mr. Pearson. Pearson needs to speak to us. Sadie. Okay. Oh, we could have some stew.
Say whatever you damn well please, but I tell you, if I don't get out of here soon, I'm gonna kill somebody.
And if you don't stop hissing at me, I'm gonna kill you.
What is wrong with you two?
I ain't chopping vegetables for a living.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam. Was there insufficient feathers in your pillow?
I ain't lazy, Mr. Morgan. I'll work, but not this.
Well, I ain't cooking work.
Oh, we have some floating cans.
My husband and I, we shared the work. All of it. I was out in the fields. I can hunt, carry a knife, or use a gun. But I tell you, you keep me here, I'll skin this fat old coot and serve him for dinner.
Watch your damn mouth, you crazy goddamn fishwife.
Enough, don't be. Come with me then. Want to head out there, run with the man? So be it. But we do more than just hunting. We're hunted. And them things hunting us, well, they got guns of their own.
I ain't afraid of dying.
Good. You need anything, Mr. Pearson? Maybe me and Miss Zed are gonna take a little ride.
Yeah, sure. Here's my list. And
I need an exorcist for those floating cans, possibly.
Sure. Come on, princess. You coming with me then, woman?
So I've graduated from chopping vegetables to shopping.
Shut your goddamn mouth.
That's good, because I wanted to go into town anyway. Good point.
Dear Aunt Kathy,
you are something else.
I haven't heard from you in some time, so I pray to the Lord above that your health has not deteriorated further. Blah, blah, blah. It's boring. Wait a sec. Listen to this. Since we last corresponded, I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself. Before you ask, I am still yet to take a wife, but I can assure you it's not for a lack of suitors. You ever actually even talked
classic
to a
Pearson
woman he ain't paid for?
Oh, look, we're all hiding behind something.
And what's this? Return to Tacitus Kilgore.
Oh, that's Dutch's idea. All mail to be sent to the same alias. Whenever we set up somewhere new, Strauss, he heads into town. Tells him to start expecting mail from a Tacitus Kilgore, whatever they changed it to. Here, give me that back. We got
work to do. Yeah.
I'm so looking forward to exploring this kind of new area. It's not really like a new area, I guess, but it's kind of really cool. Roads. It's funny because there's roads in like Assassin's Creed Odyssey as well, isn't there? It's funny.
Some good news. I received a telegram.
Okay. Here we are.
So, what's the plan? I shoot the shopkeeper while you.
No! Are you insane?
I thought we was outlaws.
Outlaws? Not idiots. We rob fools and rob other people. These people, they're just trying to get by. So you head on in there and you buy some food to eat. No guns.
For sure.
This time, there'll be time for killing soon enough.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna go check the mail. Nothing exciting.
Who's this then?
Hi, folks.
Hi there.
Hi. Hello. Alright, okay, we have posts ready here. I did actually. Should we just pop into the gunsmith quickly? I did want to buy an outfit though as well. Something befitting us a bit more in this weather.
How can I help you, miss?
It's Mrs. So I need potatoes, carrots, onions, flour, oats, salt.
I love the fact that she's actually in here buying the food.
Sure.
Like, you could just walk off and you'd never know this was happening.
Something like that. And you sell clothes?
We do. Not the widest range of ladies' fashion, I'm afraid.
That's all right. I'll look at everything you got.
Of course, Mrs.
Kilgore. I thought you were going to the post office.
Okay, that's really cool. I was. I just wanted to get here and sell some stuff. Okay. Clothing.
What? You don't even trust me to handle the shopping by myself?
I'm looking for myself. A gambler. That's cool.
Is that damn hobo slouched outside my door again? I keep telling him to move on. He'll put off my
coat. That's quite a nice shirt, actually. Oh, I like that one. What's this one like? Oh, that's fancy.
Seen what you're after?
I'm not sure that's Arthur's style. That's a bit raggedy. Okay. Maybe we go for this one. What one should we go for? I've got another blue. Pants. Fancy pants. Like these ones. And then some boots. Get some new boots. Oh, what are these? Oh yeah, I like them. Okay. Oh, we've got some riding gloves. That looks better, I think. Hello.
A lot of folks like that.
Nice. We've already got spurs, I think. got a new hat. Oh yeah, that's actually quite good, I think, with this outfit. There we go. Thank you, sir.
And that should be good.
Goodbye. Well. There we go. Arthur's looking a little bit fine again now. A little bit fine himself. The fact that we're not wearing a cloak because it's like nice and... Hello, sir. Okay.
Take a look at the catalog and I'll pull out anything you'd like to see.
I wanted to have a look at my semi-automatic shotgun. Clean it.
Well, if that gun ain't shining, glad you take care of what's yours.
Barrel.
Hey, you know that gun could use a few choice parts. Really make a sing.
Ooh, that would probably be pretty good. Range, good.
Difference.
Like the straight grain.
That's a wise investment.
Nah, no wrap.
That could really shine with some carbon in it.
Maybe not.
I've heard some unsavory things about that salesman, Virgil Fish or something. And the Yankee sympathizing is the least of it.
That's quite cool. I like it. Yeah, but black. Oh, yeah, I like that a lot.
You spend much time in the parlor
like
house? Every time I'm there, I thank God I'm armed.
No, that doesn't really suit it. Dark rosewood. There we go. Yeehaw. We need the ammunition.
Make sure you got enough rounds for it.
Awesome. Thank you, sir. I'll do the other one in a bit. Won't do it right now. Okay, we need to go to the... Oh, my horse isn't here. Forgot. Okay.
What do you mean no? What's in the park?
Look, it's an ointment, all right? For a private matter. Now I really must be going. Don't mention this to Beer.
Oh my god, this game. Let me guess, I'm going to get some trouble from these guys. Oh, no, maybe not. Send mail. Ah, bone location as well. Pay bounty. Ooh. Them some heavy bounties. Cheers.
Mister.
How
How do you do, sir?
Yeah, I do well.
Hi there.
Hello.
Go back and see Sadie, I guess. Oh, there she is. Is that her? No, that's not her. No, that is her. She's changed. Oh. Mangy dog. Mangy blue tick coot hound. Aw. Oh, bless you. What kind of dog are you?
Take that for yourself, okay?
Thanks.
We'll give it back then. Jesus. For his goddamn help. Okay, get on. I'm about done here.
Yep.
You don't need to check if I'm doing it right.
Come on. I know.
Oh, you get everything?
I think so.
And some new clothes, I see.
Don't start. I can wear what I damn well want. Like I told you, my husband and I shared all the work. I wasn't some little wife with a flower in her hair baking cherry pies all day.
Yeah, I don't doubt that. You sure look the part now. Won't be long before you're smoking cigars and playing the harmonica.
I'll have you know, I used to love playing the harmonica before. Well, my house and everything I own got burned to the ground.
I know. I'm real sorry about what you... You know.
I've got a harmonica. I found one in a stream.
I don't want no pity. Just treat me equal and know nobody's taking nothing from me ever again.
Just don't. Hey there!
Oh, hi.
What,
okay.
Just heading home.
You're in Lemoyne Raider country.
Keep it cool.
You need to pay a toll to pass through here. You don't think so? How about you pull over right now?
Pull over?
That's what I said.
Hey, how's about this?
They're dead now. Landon Ricketts. Oh shit, Sadie. You badass. I think we killed him, didn't we?
Yeah, you run, you goddamn coward! I think we're good here, Arthur. Not shooting. All right, yeah. I'll drive us back.
It wasn't bad, was it?
No, pass those reins here.
Why?
Because you've caused enough trouble already.
I'm fine.
Yep.
You those bastards, huh?
Remind me not to get on your bad side.
And they was clearly planning to bushwhack us.
Did good. But that's a lot of mess to make near camp. Hope it don't bring anyone sniffing around.
Are you gonna tell Dutch?
Maybe. If he asks. But maybe not.
Hey, you want me to drive? So who do they say they were? Lemoyne Raiders?
Yeah, something like that. Who knows? Anyway, don't you go ribbing Pearson about that letter.
How dare you? I wouldn't dream of it.
Huh. We didn't even lose our hat, by the way.
I have traveled widely, making
get yourself killed then, Miss Adler.
Not quite.
Well, I'd like to say I missed your refined conversations, but I'd be lying.
I enjoyed myself out there.
Yes, Mrs. Adler did okay.
At shopping?
Yes, at shopping.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
Don't mention it. I would ride with you again, Mrs. Adler, if you will ride with me.
Maybe. If you prove you can handle yourself.
Well, they say I lack finesse, but I ain't afraid of gun smoke.
We got this, Arthur. You've already done me a big favor today. Okay, Miss High and Mighty. And nice pants, by the way.
Oh, shut up.
Actually wanted to give him some meat, I think. Oh, looks like we've got a little house raiding mission to do over there.
Okay, Mrs. Adler.
Who said Arthur? Donate. I don't actually need food. Welcome. Anyway, we're going to actually finish up there, I think, this episode. Thank you so much for watching. It's been my pleasure. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.